Dear students, welcome to Divya's Math Solutions. Today we are going to discuss Chapter 11 Menstruation Exercise 11.2. So before that we can understand some equations. First one is the area of a trapezium. Trapezium is a four-sided figure, right? That means these two sides are parallel sides, these two are non-parallel sides, right? So how we can find the area? Height. So from anywhere we can take. So this is the height, or from here we are taking, this is also height only, right? So that means height into sum of parallel sides. So this is the one parallel side, right? So this one, if you are taking it as this is AB, this one is CD, means this AB and a CD are parallel sides. So this measurements you need to add. This is 5 and this is 8, means 5 plus 8 we need to take. That means height into sum of parallel sides divided by 2 is the area of a trapezium. Next, area of a general quadrilateral. The quadrilateral, any four-sided figure we can take generally. So here how we can take means, here half into diagonal into height 1 plus height 2. That means this is this one is a figure, a quadrilateral. Then this is a diagonal, right? That means half into diagonal. Half into diagonal and any two height. From anywhere we can take that two height. Sum of two heights we need to add and multiply with the diagonal. Then divide by 2 means what we will get? Area of general quadrilateral. Next, area of a rhombus. Area of a rhombus means how we can find out rhombus means we can find the area by diagonal 1 into diagonal 2 by 2. D1 into D2 by 2 we can take. So this is the one diagonal, this is another diagonal, multiply two diagonal, then half we are taking means what we will get? We will get the area of the rhombus. So when we are doing the problems, that time we can apply the equation. That time it become more clear. So we can go for the first question. The shape of the top surface of a table is a trapezium. See, here we can see this is a table. The top is the shape of a trapezium. Find this area if its parallel sides are 1 meter and 1.2 meter. Correct. This is a parallel sides. This is parallel to this one. So parallel sides, one is 1 meter and another one is 1 meter. And perpendicular distance between them is 0.8 meter. Perpendicular distance means what? Height, right? So everything is given. So directly we can substitute in this equation and find the area of the trapezium. So what are given? Here it is given area of the, the measurement of the parallel sides, right? So side 1 we can mention. Side 1 is 1 meter and side 2 is 1.8. 2 meter and 0.8 meter means what? That is the height, right? So h is equal to 0.8 meter we can write. Now we can substitute in this equation. So what we can write here, what we need to find? We need to find the shape of a trapezium, find the area of the table. The table is in the shape of a trapezium, right? So area of the table or area of trapezium we can write. Trapezium shape table also we can write. Okay. That is equal to height into sum of parallel sides divided by 2. Right. So here height is how much? 0.8 into sum of parallel sides are what? 1 plus 1.2 divided by 2. Right. That is equal to 0.8 into 1 plus 1.2 is how much? 2.2 divided by 2. Right. This one we can cancel. 0.4. 4.2s are 0.4. Then 0.4 into 2.2. That is 0.88. Right. 22 into 4 means how much it will come? 88. After the point, how much digit? Here 1, here 1. That means 2 points back. 0.88. Then this is the area. Area unit is what? Here the unit is meter. So meter square we need to write. Answer. Question number 2. The area of a trapezium is 34 centimeter square and length of one parallel side is 10 centimeter and its height is 4 centimeter. Find the length of the other parallel side. Here what is given? Here area is given. We need to find the length of one parallel side. Correct. So we can write what are the given statements. Area. Area of the trapezium is given as 34 centimeter square and the length of one parallel side. So side 1 we can take it as, side 1 is how much? 10 centimeter and height is also given. Height is given as 4 centimeter. We need to find the length of the other parallel side. That means side 2 we need to find out. Correct. So first we can write the area of trapezium equation. Area of trapezium is equal to height into sum of parallel sides divided by 2. Right. So here we can substitute the values. Area of trapezium we know. What is the area? 34. 34 equal to height. Height is also given. How much? 4 into sum of parallel sides. That means side 1 plus side 2. Right. Side 1 is given as 10 and the side 2 is not given. That one only we are going to find out. Divide by 2. Right. So here we can cancel. How much it will come? 2. That is equal to 34 equal to 2 into 10 plus S2 or side 2 we can write. Correct. So next day we can, this is 2 into, right? This 2 we can shift to this side. That means 34. Shifting means multiplication become division, right? 34 by 2 equal to 10 plus side 2. 34 by 2 is 1 times 17, right? So 17 equal to 10 plus side 2. From here we can write the value of side 2, right? Therefore, side 2 is equal to this 10 we are shifting. That means 17 minus 10. 17 minus 10 is how much? 7. The unit is centimeter. That means we can write, therefore, another parallel side is equal to how much we can write? 7 centimeter is the length of the other parallel side we can write. Answer. Question number 3. The length of the fence of a trapezium shaped field ABCD is 120 meter. If BC is 48 meter, CD is 17 meter, AD is 40 meter, find the area of this field. Side AB is perpendicular to the parallel side AD and BC. Right. Here the shape is given. First we can draw that figure. Okay, A, B, D, C, this is perpendicular. Okay, the length of the fence of a trapezium shaped field is A, B, C, D is 120 meter. So, here the length of the fence is given as, length of the fence means what? Perimeter is given, right? That means perimeter is 120 meter for this trapezium shaped field. Perimeter means what? Sum of all the sides, right? That is given as 120 meter. If BC is 48 meter, BC 48 meter, CD 17 meter and AD 40 meter, find the area of this field. We need to find the area of this trapezium and side AB is perpendicular to the parallel side. Which one? Side AB. AB is perpendicular to the parallel side AD and BC. So this is perpendicular to here and here it is perpendicular also given. Correct. So first here it is given perimeter is 120 meter. Right. So what we need to find? We need to find the area. So how we can find the area? Area we can find it as area is sum of parallel side into height. Right. So half into sum of parallel side. Here what are the parallel side? BC and AD are the parallel side. Right. That means BC plus AD. Sum of parallel sides into height. What is the height over here? AB is the height. This is the equation for the trapezium. Right. Equation of a trapezium is sum of parallel side into height divided by 2. Right. So 1 by 2 into here this BC and AD are parallel. The sum means BC plus AD and height is the perpendicular distance, that is AB. So if you are substituting all these volumes, we can find the area of this field. Correct. So here what are the known values? BC we know, AD also we know, but AB we don't know. Right. So, but what is given? Perimeter is given. Perimeter means what? Sum of all the sides. The three sides are known. Only one side is missing. So, from there we can find the value of AB. Correct. So, perimeter. Perimeter is equal to AB plus BC plus CD plus AD equal to 120 meter. We can write. That means perimeter means sum of all the sides. Right. So here we can substitute the values. AB we don't know, that we are going to find out. BC is 48, CD is 17 and AD is 40 equal to 120 meter. Right. So this one we can add everything. So AB plus 48 plus 40 is 88 plus 17 is 90, 95, 105, right? 105 equal to 120. So therefore AB equal to 120 minus 105. 120 minus 105 is 50 meter, right? So now we have the value of AB. So now we can substitute the values over here, means we can find the area of this field, right? So area of this trapezium shaped field, this is equal to area of the field, this is equal to, here we can substitute, that means half into BC. BC is how much? BC is 48 plus AD. AD is how much? 40 into AB. AB is, now we got the value as 50. So this is equal to half into 40 plus 48 is 88 into 15. Here 44. 15 into 44. 15. 44 into 15 we need to do. 5 4 20. 22. 4 4 0 6. 660. So 660 unit is area means square only. So here it is meter means meter square is the area of the trapezium shaped field. We can write answer. Question number 4. The diagonal of a quadrilateral shaped field is 24 meter. This is the diagonal. Quadrilateral means what? Four-sided figure, right? Here this is the diagonal is 24 meter and the perpendicular dropped on it from the remaining opposite vertices are 8 meter and 13 meter. This is the perpendicular. Perpendicular means what? That is the height, right? Two heights are given. Find the area of this field. Here here we are going to find the area of this field, right? So what is the general equation? So area of the quadrilateral, we can take it as half into diagonal into height 1 plus height 2, right? So this one we can write the what we need to find. We need to find the area, right? Area of the field equal to half into diagonal into h1 plus h2, right? So here we can substitute the values. Half into, here what is the diagonal? 24 is the diagonal. 24 into h1, that means two heights, right? Two heights are given. One height is 13 and another height is 8. So we can simplify this one. This one, 12 2s are 24. So 12 into 13 plus 8 is 21. 21 into 12, we can multiply. 2 4 1 2 252, that is equal to 252 meter square is the area of the field. Answer. Next question number 5. Question number 5. The diagonal of a rhombus are 7.5 centimeter and 12 centimeter. Find its area. So what is the area of a rhombus? Diagonal 1 into diagonal 2 divided by 2 is the area of the rhombus, right? Here two diagonals are given. So first diagonal we can take it as D1. D1 is 7.5 centimeter and D2 is 12 centimeter, correct? So we need to find the area of the rhombus. So area of the rhombus equal to half into D1 into D2, that is equal to half into, here D1 is 7.5, D2 is 12. 6 2s are 12. 7.75 into 6 we can find. 6 7s are 42, 45. 1 point back means 45. 45 unit is centimeter square. So area of the rhombus is 45 centimeter square, we can write. Next question number 6. Question number 6 is, find the area of a rhombus whose side is 6 cm and whose altitude is 4 cm. If one of the diagonal is 8 cm long, find the length of the other diagonal. So here we need to find the area of the rhombus. So here it is given, one side is 6 cm and the altitude means height is given as 4 cm and one diagonal is given, we need to find the other diagonal, right? So what is the general equation for finding the rhombus? Half into D1 into D2 is the equation, right? So here what is the value is known, only D1 is known, D2 is unknown, that we are going to find out. That is the one part. Then we need to find the area of the rhombus also, correct? So rhombus is rhombus means what? That is a kind of parallelogram only, right? So if you are taking This is the parallelogram. So if I take this figure like this, means what? That looks like a rhombus only, right? That means this this one rhombus is a kind of a parallelogram only, right? So we can go for the equation of parallelogram to find the area of the rhombus. So area of rhombus equal to area of rhombus is equal to area of parallelogram. We can write. Why here you need to write? Because the rhombus is a kind of parallelogram. We need to write in bracket because rhombus is a kind of parallelogram. That's why we are using the equation for parallelogram to find the area of the rhombus. So area of rhombus is equal to area of parallelogram. So what is the area of parallelogram? Base into altitude is the base into height is the which one area of the parallelogram, correct? So here it is given, find the area of the rhombus whose side. Side means what? Any side we can take it as base. That means 6 into and altitude. Altitude means what? Height, right? That is 4 centimeters. So 6 into 4 is equal to 24 centimeter square is the area of the rhombus. So we know the equation for finding the area of the rhombus directly. What is the equation? Half into divided into d2. So this is a one part. We need to find the area of the rhombus. So we area of the rhombus we are finding using the area of the parallelogram. Why? Because rhombus is a kind of parallelogram only, right? Next we are going to find the another diagonal, right? One diagonal is given d1. Diagonal is 8 centimeter long. We need to find another diagonal. That means d2 we are going to find out, right? So here we are going to use the equation of area of rhombus. Area of rhombus is equal to half into d1 into d2. Here we can substitute the area of the rhombus. What is the area of rhombus? 24 equal to half into d1 is 8 and d2 we are going to find out. Here we can cancel. 4 2 is 8, right? So here we can write 24 is equal to 4 into d2. So what is the value of d2? D2 equal to this 4 we are shifting. Multiplication we are shifting means multiplication become division, right? That means 24 by 4. 6 4s are 24. So d2 is equal to 6 centimeter. We can write answer.